Hey guys, welcome to another recap of Survivor: Heroes versus Villains. Last week, Tom was voted off. All right, this week at the Heroes Tribe, they got back from, tribal council, and James was asking Colby if he wanted a hug, and Colby was all like, "No, I'm good." And James was like, "Really?" And then Amanda was like, "Ugh, I want Candace off. I hate her, 'cause James is so nice." All right, so at the Villains Tribe, Russell couldn't sleep and neither could Boston Rob. So they have a little meeting of the minds in the dark around the gnarly tree root. And Russell tries to make Boston Rob think that everything's cool. Everything's okay. I don't have the idol. I want to be your friend kind of thing. And Boston Rob is like, no, I'm not buying it. Better kiss your ass goodbye, because if I have anything to do with it, you're going to be out of here. So it's time for the challenge, and it was pretty unclear from the tree mail that they had gotten that it's going to be a immunity and reward challenge, and somebody is going home from both tribes. So it's going to be an individual immunity situation, one per tribe, and the winners of the individual immunity are going to be facing off against each other to win a hot dog and sody party for their tribe to be eaten while they watch somebody go home from the other tribe. Now, Tyson actually had this during his season, this challenge, and he won. So it's interesting. The heroes go first because they lost the coin toss, and Candace ends up winning individual immunity. Colby totally sucked at this. He kind of got stuck in the maze because he's kind of fat. Oh, did I happen to mention it was a rope maze? A ropes obstacle course maze? I guess I probably didn't. Well, there, I just did it. And James was actually doing really well in this, even though his leg was messed up. So James' opinion of his hero, Colby, has kind of gone south. So the villains get to go next after they watch the heroes do it. And Boston Rob freaking flew through this, and he won individual immunity. So now for the big face-off between Rob and Candace. It is a giant three-story rope obstacle course maze. And Candace was really keeping up with Boston Rob, but in the end, Boston Rob is Boston Rob, and he won immunity. Well, not immunity. He won the hot dog and sody party for his tribe. So this is how it's going to go down. The villains are going to have their tribal council. Then they're going to trot in the heroes. And while the heroes do theirs, the villains are going to eat their hot dogs and soda. So Rob warns Russell. He said, "You're going to go home. So if you don't have the idol, you better find it." So he kind of, threw down the gauntlet, whatever you want to call it. He slapped him across the face with the leather glove. And Russell has figured out that they're going to be targeting Parvati. So he's going to put Tyson's name down on his little piece of parchment, and he's going to give the idol to Parvati. That's his big plan. So that in that way, I guess he can save himself and Parvati. So the heroes tribe, Colby, is pretty bummed out, and he's pretty much prepared to be falling on his sword. So Colby goes and makes his peace with James, but James is a bitch, and he's just like, Superman, you're fat. I don't like you, I don't know. I thought it was nice that Colby was kind of extending the olive branch to James, but James was, I don't know what's with him. Every season that he's on, he always starts out nice, and then he gets all freaky, and it really messes with me. So James thinks Superman sucks now because Colby was on like 10 years ago for his season. And yeah, people get older, James. Same thing's gonna happen to you. You might not think so right now, but creeps up on you before you know it. So Amanda is having a mini freakout because she gets wind of everybody thinking that maybe they should be getting rid of James because he's still not 100%, and he eats all the bananas and he never offers bananas to anyone else. I don't know what is up with that, but I don't know why that would bother people. I mean, can't you just get your own bananas? Aren't there like bananas everywhere? So she runs over to James and is like, "You're going to have to prove that You're still good. Otherwise, they're gonna get rid of you. So James like goes to JT and Rupert and is like, "We're gonna have to have a race so I could show that I'm okay. I don't want to just run around by myself, so I want to race JT." So it was so weird that the two of them had this race on the beach, and James sucked so bad that JT still beat him running backwards. So he also explains that I'm not gonna hoggle the bananas anymore. I'm gonna get bananas for you guys too. So it was just like really weird. JT and Rupert were probably just like, "What have you been smoking?" All right, at the villains tribe, Rob realizes that he needs an insurance policy because Russell's pretty slimy. So he comes up with this brilliant, genius plan. Three votes for Poverty, three votes for Russell, and then whatever three votes they vote. So that will cover them in all situations, whether Russell uses the idol on himself or whether he gives it to Poverty. So Russell, sensing that there's this other plan, or maybe somebody just told him, I don't know, because I really don't think he's that smart. Russell tells Tyson that he's going to vote for Poverty. And Tyson thinks that he's going to vote for Poverty too, so that they can avoid this whole revote and everything like that. So, by the way, Russell thinks the three-way vote is genius, and it is, but he doesn't think that they are smart enough to pull it off. So, at the Villains Tribal Council, the hidden immunity idol is something that's new, especially to Boston Rob, because they didn't have it in his season. But everybody on the tribe knows that Russell has it this season. And Russell is still all like, "I don't have it. I don't know what to talk about. I don't have it." And Sandra tells him, "Well, you better find it if you don't have it then, because you're probably going to need it." Jeff senses a little uncertainty in the voting. His Jeff Probst Spidey senses are tingling, I suppose. So it's time for the vote, and Russell plays the idol for Parvati. I was like, "What?" Yeah. That's like one of the first times I've ever seen somebody give it away like that when it was so uncertain. I mean, that was a bold move. I gotta give him that much. It was a bold move. Because he didn't know that Tyson was gonna switch his vote, or maybe he did. But it ended up four votes for Parvati because Tyson switched his vote, three votes for Tyson, and two for Russell. So Russell was safe and he saved Parvati. That was like a miracle. So bring out the hot dogs and soda. Tyson's gone. So they get to sit there, and let me tell you, those hot dogs looked delish, like with home-baked buns. They were really good. I don't know whether the soda was cold or not. It looked like it was. It was in a big barrel. The Heroes Tribal is starting. Everyone, get your hot dogs and soda. So, yeah, we find out that James is still not 100%, but we knew that already. And the whole Superman is in a fat suit, comes out, and if I was Colby, I'd feel pretty embarrassed, but Jay, I don't know, James should just shut his mouth. It's so stupid, the whole thing. Well, I guess he will be shutting his mouth because he's drunk and he's voted out. So it was kind of low clay. I'm gonna get drunk in 5 minutes. Okay, go ahead. Superman is staying because a fat Superman is better than a broken banana hog, right, James? I don't know why I didn't like James this season. It's just he just weirded me out. I just did not like his attitude at all. It's like, "Oh, this is my third time on. Maybe I can be a jerk." Well, you're probably a jerk the second and first time around too. Next time, it's Rob versus Russell again. I hope Rob wins. Till next time, much love.